set to go, kicking it off for the Ravens. It'll be senior kicker Mark Gormley. And the ball is away. It's high in over in. It's going to be taken on the run at the 15-yard line. At the 20, 25, they'll take it to the left side. Bringing the ball back upfield is going to be the Broncos to the 34-yard line. A nice return all the way up to the 34-yard line. And it is going to be first and 10 right there. We're still trying to pick up the number of the young man who made the return. 14:55 to go, we're underway. And with they'll spot the ball down at the 34-yard line. First down and 10 for Hastings. The Broncos will step out of the huddle and come up in the split backs formation. Receivers left and right for Bingman. Now a motion man to the left side. Long count, quarterback hands off into the middle of the line. Good run across the 35, 37, maybe the 38-yard line. Good carry on the play. Running it right into the middle of the line is Gordon Witten. And he's going to be tackled by McGibney in the center of the line for Benedictine College along with Randy Salzer. Second down and 5. Right away, Hastings has decided they're going to try to establish the ground game. They're going to try to see if they're going to be able to run against this highly touted Benedictine defense. Second down and 5. From the 38-yard line, Hastings in their own end. They're going to go to a single setback. Motion man to the right side, receivers left and right. Handoff, middle of the line, hit head on! On a great defensive play by Greg Bauer. The running back who tried to sweep to the left side and nowhere for Bill Barta to go on that carry. It'll be a short gain on the carry up to about the 40-yard line. And Greg Bauer, he's been a headhunter for this Raven defensive unit all season long. And he makes an impressive tackle there for the gain of a pair of third down 3. Big third down call as Benedictine has shown all of the confidence in the world in their defensive unit by putting them on the field. Single set back in the backfield. Two to the left side again for Bingman. Third down 3 from their own 40. Quarterback hands off, swim to the outside, looking for somewhere to go. Hit, drop down by McGuire. The sweet man coming to the near side on a little reverse play was tackled by McGuire on an outstanding defensive play. And Gordon Witten had nowhere to go. He may have picked up a yard. It's fourth down and apparent quickly. The punting unit races in. Brown and Romp are back deep for Benedictine to take the punt. And it is a poor one. It landed at the Raven 40. And it will take a Bronco bounce to the 35 where they'll down it. And so Benedictine, I'm not really so sure if they decided that they really wanted to put the defense on the field first, or maybe they just decided this brisk northerly breeze would be best at their back in the first quarter. Maybe just decided to put the defense out solely on getting the direction they wanted to have. Whichever way it was, it apparently has worked out for the Ravens, and the defense is held on the initial series of the ball game, and the Ravens will put their offense on the field. First and 10 from just outside their own 35-yard line. Quarterback Chris Tabor will bring him with a single back in the backfield. They're going to have Harbison in, and he'll shuffle over to the right side, tight end. Motion man to the near side, Perez. First and 10, Ravens. The handoff, Torline. He'll hit to the outside and pick up about 3. Torline wrapped up by Pat Fisher. He does a nice job from that outside linebacker spot. That time immediately got to the outside, shook his block, and made the tackle after the gain of a couple of yards for Steve Torline. And the Ravens going with that traditional no-huddle offense are back at the line of scrimmage. Wide to the left side for the Ravens will be Marcinowski, and it'll be Perez filling the slot left. And the Ravens will shift back to the I formation, Brown behind Torline. A little extra time for this play as the Ravens look over to the near side to get the call. Second down, 8. Now I think Tabor maybe is changing it off of the line of scrimmage. He drops back, looks, has a man over the middle, and caught by Marcinowski at the 50. He's at the 45-yard line. Chris Marcinowski is tackled by Don Heelan and Doug Herbeck. And it's going to be a first and 10. Benedictine on the pass play to the Bronco 45. Nice play by Tabor. And if he did check that off of the line of scrimmage, he certainly saw something that worked. Good yardage for Benedictine. Brown will now go to the slot position to the right side. We still haven't seen Don Brown carry the football. 12-10 to play opening quarter. Harbison will shift to the left side. Torline remains in the backfield. Motion man Perez takes it to the right side where there will be now 3 receivers. Hand off Torline, breaks it across the left side of the 41. Steve Torline on a little slant run to the left side. Don Hewlett again makes the tackle. Hewlett, the second leading interception man for this Hastings defense, has 5 interceptions on the season. Ralph Reese with a half dozen on the year. Second down, 6. Ravens at the Bronco 41. One thing Benedictine and I think Coach Wilcox intimated this a little bit in the pregame show, they would just like to come out and dominate from the very beginning, much as they've done so often this year. The pitch to Brown. He's at the 40. He's at the 36-yard line where a trio of men bring him to the ground, led by Ryan Fahey and Don Helat. Notice we've mentioned Don Helat's name, three consecutive tackles. I would assure you that you do not want to have your cornerback making tackles three consecutive plays. That is an immediate indication that Benedictine has been able to gain too much yardage. The officials are going to stop the clock for just a moment. They get things set up on the field, and now we're back to football again on a third down and one. Benedictine at the Bronco 36-yard line. Tabor looks left and right now, steps up again with a single back behind him. They'll shift the tight end to the left side. Movement on the defensive front. They'll make a change in the middle. Handoff, Torlein bounces to the outside, powers forward. He'll pick up the first down. An initial indication, it looks like he's gotten just to the 35, where big Chris Pohl and Pat Fisher are in to make the tackle for the Broncos. The official lines it up, looks across, first and 10, Ravens. 10:43 to play in the opening quarter. Benedictine with its first possession of the ball game, moving it downfield for the first and 10 at the Bronco 35. Wide now to the right side. We'll go Marcinowski. Perez will fill the slot once more. Tabor very calm, very patient. The senior, he's been running this offense for 3 years now. Keeps it himself, skirts to the left side, to the 32-yard line, and a penalty marker sail. A penalty marker lying on the turf near the point of tackle. And we're going to get the call from the official here in just a moment. Holding against Benedictine. Jerry Drake moved over along with Herbeck to make the tackle on Tabor. But that's going to be called back, and then the penalty added to it. As the Ravens getting downfield, trying to get some downfield blocking for Tabor, are guilty of a hold. 10:24 to go in this opening quarter. The wind at the Ravens' back. And warming up along the near sideline for Benedictine College's Gormley, but still a long way away, and now with this 10-yard penalty, a lot further away. First and 20 for the Ravens. The Benedictine offense really not any ground-oriented offense, not geared to pick up the big yardage. And the first and 20 presents an immediate problem as we approach 10 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Ravens have gone to the huddle now as they have the time has stopped and the momentum of the ball game has slowed a little bit. Now the Ravens have come out over the football. Now they're going to call timeout. Tabor just is not comfortable with it, and we will have a timeout taken just 5 minutes into the ball game. 9 minutes and 59 seconds to play in the first quarter of the game, and a timeout on the field with the score. Benedictine nothing and Hastings nothing. Back at Amelia Earhart Stadium, first down and 20, Benedictine. And the handoff into the middle of the line, Torlein, he's hit, bounces away, and will pick up maybe a yard. Certainly no more than that, as Pat Fisher met him, brought him to the ground, and along with Gerald Hunt, makes the tackle for the Broncos. The Ravens now second and 19. Long way to go for Benedictine. Quickly back to the line of scrimmage they'll come. Tabor steps over, takes a long look. I don't know if they're changing something on him or he just wants to be very, very certain that he has in what he wants to have. Two receivers right, one receiver left. Torlein remains a single back for Benedictine on the second down and 19. Deep drop, pass on the near side is thrown well out of bounds, incomplete. An excellent diving attempt by Chris Marcinowski to pull it in, but the pass was thrown to the left side, which is the out-of-bounds side. And with a man-to-man coverage, Don Helat was right over there, providing really good coverage. That was a deep drop by Tabor on that play. He must have taken at least seven steps back. Clock stops with the incompleted pass at 9:17 to go. The Ravens facing a third down and very long, third and 19 at the Bronco 44. And the Ravens will shift to the shotgun formation, something I expect to see from Hastings a good deal this afternoon. Back to throw. Tabor sets up, looks downfield, has Marcinowski. He gets bumped, and there's a pass. Marcinowski got bumped around the 13-yard line, and the penalty marker sails at that spot. It will be first and 10 for the Ravens as the pass interference call will be assessed. It was a beautifully called pass and very patient with Chris Tabor. He waited for his receiver to get downfield. He waited for him to break free, and then just after he released the ball was in flight. And the defender came over and gave him a little bit of a shove. And Don Helat is going to be guilty of the foul, and the Ravens will pick up a very important first and 10. And they keep this initial drive alive with 9:12 to play in the opening quarter. We're still scoreless from Amelia Earhart Stadium in Atchison, Kansas.
It's 15.
The Broncos of Hastings College took the opening kickoff, were stopped in three downs, punted the football away. Morgan. And back to the... And the Ravens took the ball and now move it upfield. Kind of Benedictine football alums coming in here today. First and 10, just inside the 30-yard line for the Ravens. Hand off Brown. Penalty marker sails. Brown will gain a yard to the left side. I expect another holding call in that location as Jason Main making a tackle for the Hastings Football Club, but we'll wait and see what it is. Again, it's in that location we expect the same thing that caused the Ravens a problem a moment ago, and that is a holding call. No, it's going to be encroachment on the defense. One of the Broncos must have lined up in the neutral zone or maybe gotten off a little quickly, but at any rate, it's going to make a first down and 5 for the Ravens. 9:07 to go.
Does he get the 1 yard
down? So mark it down at the 25-yard line. That will erase the Don Brown run. So officially, he still hasn't carried the ball this afternoon. 9:03 to go.
Yeah, he has.
First and 5 at the 25. Penalty markers again. This is one thing I didn't expect in the course of this ball game, is this many penalties, certainly this early in the afternoon. We'll wait and see what the officials call here. Ravens had it at the 25-yard line with a first down and 5. And we'll see what happens. Both officials are going to both sidelines. They had a problem with the spot of the football, and now they're going to reset it again. They're going to put it just inside the 25-yard line. 8:49 to play. Well, it's been a kind of an interesting first quarter. Not exactly, again, what I would have expected to see happen, but Ravens continue to move the football downfield. Marcinowski wide to the right side. An I-left formation. The handoff to the outside is Brown. He's in trouble. Moves downfield and picks up a yard or two. And tackled about 3 yards out of play by Gerald Hunt. It'll be a gain of maybe a yard, no more than that. As it was a good job of getting into the offensive backfield very quickly by this Hastings team. And I tell you, if you don't think they're going to be looking for Don Brown this afternoon, then I think you way underestimate them, because he has got to be the guy any team would key on. DeAndre in the backfield. The handoff to Brown. He's going to be hit, and hit again. Swarmed over for a loss. Brown is hit and powered to the ground. There are 9 Broncos at the point of tackle. When it stops, it's going to be the loss of about 3. Third down for Benedictine College. Third down, 8. 8:05 to play in a scoreless first quarter. And right now, you can tell where Hastings has placed his attention. And that's on Don Brown. However, the Raven offense, more multifaceted than that. And it is more than just Don Brown, and I'm sure that the Ravens will show us a lot more looks as we go on through the afternoon. Quarterback play action, back to throw his Tabor. In trouble, hit from the blind side, releases the ball, caught for a first down. From his knees, leaning forward, Chris Marcinowski makes the catch, and Benedictine picks up the first down. Roger Perkins making the stop for the Broncos. But a great job by Marcinowski. He turned, came back, fell to his knees, leaned forward, and caught the ball while falling toward the ground to pick up a first and 10 for the Ravens. Got the ball at the 16-yard line. 7.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. An incredibly time-consuming possession by the Ravens. The pitch to Brown. He hits the outside. He's to the 15. He's to the 10. He's to the 8-yard line. Don Brown, they'll mark him down at the 9. They'll say he's touchdown at the 9-yard line. It's going to be a gain of about 6. 7:10 to play, and continuing to roll in the first quarter. We're scoreless. The Ravens now threatening. And Benedictine has done a fine job of mixing in the pass with the run to keep this drive successful. As a matter of fact, the three biggest plays in the drive have all been pass plays. From the eye, quarterback keeps it, nearly loses it, keeps it himself, goes to the five, cuts inside the five, and it's going to be near first down and a very late marker falls down at the point of tackle. A very late penalty comes down, possibly a face mask type of thing. A holding call against Benedictine. It's going to be the call. And a tough break for the Ravens, who looked as though they might have been around first in goal range. But instead, this ball is going to be taken back again. 6:46 to go in the opening quarter. Jesper Johansson checks out of the ball game. Not hard to miss him. The penalty is going to be marked off and assessed back to the 17, where we'll bring up a second and 11. Second down and 11 yards to go for the Ravens. Back at the 17-yard line. Marcinowski to the left side, Perez in the slot. High formation in the backfield. A lot of movement on the defense. Quarterback is back to throw. Sets up, fires. He's looking for Javier and is nearly intercepted. Almost taken by Roger Perkins in the end zone. The Ravens very lucky not to have turned over the football on that play. Clock stops with 6:26 to go, and the pass thrown a little deep. And again, maybe with a very brisk wind at Chris Tabor's back. He may have carried that football a little bit on him and let it go further downfield than he anticipated it going. Nonetheless, it's now third down, and the clock stops. Is Benedictine going to take their second timeout of the half here? And we will take the timeout also. 6 minutes and 26 seconds to play in the first quarter, and the score, Benedictine nothing, Hastings nothing. It's third down and 11, and Tabor's back to throw, sets up, fires a pass, incomplete. And Tabor is down on the ground. He was knocked to the ground and a penalty marker again, near where the pass was thrown. It was thrown again toward Marcinowski, and another penalty marker lays there at the 5-yard line. Again, great pressure put on, this time by Jerry Drake, 6'5", 285. And they're going to call an offensive pass interference call against Benedictine. The decision for Hastings, do you accept the penalty or do you decline it? It's going to be an interesting decision to see made. I'm not so sure they would not say, no, we don't want it. And not give the round, they're going to take it. They've decided to give Benedictine another opportunity, but accept the penalty, which will push the football back to the 31. And the official's going to set it on the field now. 6:21 to go in the first quarter. Benedictine has been penalized already in this quarter, probably more than they have in many games this season. It's not been as smoothly played as I think Coach Wilcox would like. But again, a lot of times you have those butterflies. It's going to be a loss of down on the offensive pass interference. And a Benedictine kicking unit will come onto the field. Nettles in the game. Bill Nettles in Benedictine's post-regular season game last year at the Steamboat Bowl. One of the greatest punting performances I've ever seen. And a great part of the reason why the Ravens were able to come away with the win. Delay of game against Benedictine. This probably is an intentional play, though. Ravens are going to give Nettles a little more room to kick because with a good foot and a very brisk breeze at his back, there's no question he will be able to push this ball out of the back of the end zone, and that's not his goal here at this point. So the Ravens taking this penalty by choice as much as anything else. He'll stand now, Nettles, at his own 48, waiting the snap of the football. It's a good win. He'll take it and boot it away, angling it to the right sideline. This ball is going to land at the one and go all the way through the back of the end zone. And Hastings is going to come out with the football first and 10 at its own 20-yard line. And I'm going to tell you, you hear him in the background in the crowd? There are a lot of people who made the trip down from Nebraska for this game for Hastings. The Ravens taking up probably 8 minutes on a series that does not culminate in points. And they get the football back to Hastings College. First and 10 at their own 20. Coach Dan Kratzer has no doubt had his Broncos over the sideline and maybe making a few offensive adjustments. Sailors will come to the near side. Todd Athey to the far side. Split backs for Bingman. Now motion man to the near side will be Barda. Quarterback hands off to Whitten. He'll hit the middle of the line. Angle off. McGivney hits him. Another Raven hits him. And finally, spinning forward to continue to drive to the 24-yard line. Tom Hampton, the final Raven, in on the tackle of Gordon Whitten. Whitten, 1,259 yards on the season, averaging over 5 yards per carry. Picked up four that time. As we are under 6 minutes to go in the first quarter, it's a second down, half a dozen for the Broncos. Going wide to the left side now is Nick Ratzlaff. Footbacks again for Bingman. Long count. He will hand off to his big fullback, Whitten. He'll power to the right side. Go to the 25, the 26-yard line, where he's hit very quickly by Joe Burke for Benedictine. Going to be a gain of a pair, second and four. The ball at the 26. Plays are being shuttled in and out from the far sideline. Back into the ball game is Brad McCaslin. And Sailors is going to check out. So right now, Coach Kratzer will use his receiving core to bring the plays in and out of the ball game. McCaslin will come to the near side. Athey will go to the far side. And now in the shotgun, Bingman steps back to take the snap. Pushing man to the left side is Whitten. Quarterback is back to throw. Steps up, feels some heat, thinks about running with the football, gets a great block, is going to be hit, he's going to be stopped a yard short. Bauer was the first man in, but when Joe McGuire came in, put a hit on him with Frank Goa, they stopped the forward momentum, and it's going to be another punting situation for Hastings. The Raven defense playing very, very sharp in the first two opportunities on the field, and you can hear the roar of approval for the Raven fans. Romp and Brown again back deep to field the kick. The snap is back. The boot is away. Into this wind, it is not very good. At the 45, it bounces. Takes a Bronco bounce, but the Ravens will have it across midfield at the Hastings 48-yard line. 4 minutes and 17 seconds ago in what remains a scoreless game. And wait a minute, another penalty is on the field. It's going to be holding against Hastings. And will the Ravens ask them to kick it over?
No.
The football right now at the Bronco 48-yard line. We get the official. They're going to call personal foul against Hastings. I thought it was going to be a holding call, but they're going to make a personal call, foul call, and that will be taken back. That's going to be a dead ball foul. That is going to leave the Raven offense in there, and instead of the 48-yard line, it's going to have it at the 33. So Benedictine picks up 15 yards right there and is going to be back nearly where they ended their last series. 4:17 to play. Now it's been something of a bizarre opening quarter. We're scoreless yet from Atchison, Kansas. Don Brown will sprint from the tailback position to the slot place on the left side. Quarterback Tabor again back to look. He's in trouble. Hit as he releases the ball, and it's overthrown over the head of Don Brown. And a tremendous hit was put on by Jerry Drake on Chris Tabor. That's the second time Drake has driven Tabor to the ground. And at 6'5", 285, he's going to be a difficult man to stop. And we have another penalty marker down. This one on the line of scrimmage against Benedictine College. Probably just as well that the ball wasn't caught, because a holding penalty would have taken it away. Long discussion is going to be held out between the officiating crew and Pat Fisher, the linebacker for Hastings, and their defensive captain, who will use his judgment and say, let's take this penalty, march it back 10. 4 minutes and 11 seconds to go. And what has not been an especially briskly moving first quarter. It'll be pushed back all the way to the 46-yard line, first down and 22.
10-yard penalty brings up first and 20 for Benedict.
First down and 22. It's marked off from the point of infraction. In with the I formation in the backfield, a pitch to Brown. He gets to the outside. He's at the 50, 45. He's at the 42 in the corner at the 35. Drags the tackler to the 30-yard line. Don Brown with a good acceleration to the left side, and Don Hewlett making the stop for Hastings. A nice carry by Don Brown. He'll pick up about 14, make it a second down in about 7 or 8. 3:45 to go in the first quarter. Benedictine has shown an ability to move the football, and at this point have been their own worst enemy with so many penalties assessed. Shifting of the offense leaves two to the left side, one to the right. Now that man will come in motion to the left. Three receivers all to the short side of the field. And the handoff to Torline. He's at the middle of the 25. 20, 15, 10, Torline's at the 5. Touchdown, Ravens. And no markers this time.
Great call.
call by Benedictine as they put the motion in. They put everybody to the short side of the field, handed off Torline off right tackle. He broke into the secondary, cut immediately across the green, and with 3:23 to go in the opening quarter, Benedictine College has broken out on top. We await the extra point attempt for Benedictine by Mark Gormley. Nettles will hold the football. A splendid run that time by Torline. Hands outstretched, the ball is placed down, the kick is up, on its way, it is good. And we've got a timeout on the field. Timeout with 3:23 to go in the first quarter of play, and your score, Benedictine College 7 and Hastings nothing. The kick is taken on the left side by Hastings College. Steve Chandler will take it. He'll go to the left of the 20 and at the 25-yard line. He's going to be hit and upended at the 28. And that is where Hastings will have its first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Greg Bauer, a tremendous hit on the kick coverage team for the Ravens, and Benedictine at this point in the ball game is fired up for up, and the momentum has shifted early here to the Ravens' side. Roger Bingman continues to impress me. This young man, a freshman out there running this ball club. Single set back to men to the right side now. And the handoff to the fullback. He'll follow the blocking into the middle of the line, and Bill Barta will pick up short yardage. A couple of yards, maybe around the 30, and that's going to be about all, as it going will be throughout the day. Very, very tough into the middle of the line. Ken McGibney, along with Burke and Salzer for the Ravens. Burke comes up holding an ankle a little bit. Probably somebody stepped on him and cleated him a little bit on that tackle, as there was just a mass of people in the middle. Second down, 8 from their own 30-yard line for Hastings College. Motion man to the near side is Sailors. Quarterback hands off, second man into the line, hit and driven back. McGibney with a big hit for Benedictine. He simply put his head in the numbers of Gordon Winton and drove him backward and into the ground for a gain of a yard, a very hard-earned yard to the 31. 2:20 to play in the first quarter. Going out of the ball game, the two starting running backs for Hastings, Winton and Barta, go out. And so you know what that means. They're intending to throw the football on 3rd down 7. 2 minutes now to go. Bingman will drop back to the shotgun formation. He'll bring the big tight end, Wade Fleischer, to the right side. Quarterback's back, looks for the man over the middle. It's caught at the 35, but way short of the first down. Has a hit by Greg Bauer on Kent Sailors. Little crossing play, very like the Benedictine ISO pass, where you bring the man across in the middle of the zone. And once again, Hastings has been held to 3 downs and out. And the Ravens have not given up a first down today. A minute 35 to go in the first quarter. The snap is back. The punt is away. It is high, hanging. Fair catch called for and made and then dropped as somebody was hit. And I can't believe there wasn't a marker dropped on that, as Brown stepped up to take the catch. He was hit and pushed back. And now the officials having a little discussion right at that point. A minute 24 to go in the first quarter. Torline steps up. He wants to have a little piece of the conversation, at least know what's going on. And the last man for Benedictine to make his way to the huddle is going to be Chris Tabor. No penalties, no damage, no penalty, and the Ravens are just going to have the football, first and 10 at their own 43-yard line with a minute 24 to go. A minute 24 to play in the opening quarter, 7-0 Ravens. Benedictine scored on its last possession of the football. Harbison will move over. He'll be the tight end now on the left side. Perez will go motion to the right from the eye. Quarterback keeps it, cuts, turns, throws the field, and is brutally tackled. And again, the guy who's been doing the damage is Jerry Drake. He has been coming from the left defensive side, sweeping around. Jason Main got in front of him, and then Drake caught him from behind. And he has been someone the Ravens have not blocked out particularly well here in the first quarter. 1 minute to play in the first quarter. Ravens leading it here 7-0. Again, an eye formation. Perez right, Marcinowski left. Tabor looking across at four down linemen, makes a pitch. Brown drops it, loses it, and very wisely just covers up the football at the Benedictine 37. There's going to be a loss on the carry of probably 6 or 7 yards, but nonetheless, as Jason Main put the hit on Tabor as he pitched the ball. It was a very, very smart thing to do by Brown. Don't try to pick it up and run it and take a chance of losing a handle on the ball. Instead, you just cover it up and come back for another play. A play which will probably be the last play of the first quarter as we're down now 15 seconds. Again with the I formation, third down and long. Play action, back to throw. Looking for Marcinowski. The pass is going to be incomplete, overthrown. Outstanding coverage downfield again by Don Hewlett for Hastings. And the clock will stop with 7 seconds to go, and Benedictine will pump the ball away for the second time today. Bill Nettles will stand around his own 20-yard line, and this time, with the wind behind him, this is a good call, too, because if you've got a punt, you want to have 7 seconds left to kick with the wind in this first quarter. Hands outstretched by Nettles, and he just wants all of it, and gets away, a nice kick. It will be taken around the 30-yard line. Tremendous block, but not enough as Johnson comes down and makes a spinning tackle of Steve Chandler. Chandler, on two consecutive returns, has been hit very, very hard, and we have come to the end of the first quarter of play. Timeout on the field from Amelia Earhart Stadium in Atchison, Kansas. After one quarter of play, the score is Benedictine 7, Hastings nothing.
I'm getting nervous, right?
First play of the second quarter is a pitch from Bingman to Witten, and as he tries to get to the outside, he turns a corner and is hit and then hit again and driven down by McGibney. It's going to be a gain of 2. Second down and 8 for Hastings from their own 38-yard line. Good to have you along with us this Saturday afternoon. Just underway in the second quarter of the ball game. Benedictine College leading Hastings 7-0 in this NAIA playoff game from Atchison, Kansas. Split back to the backfield again for Roger Bingman. He will drop back. Short drop, sets up to throw, has a man wide over to the right flank, and it's completed the 45. And a good individual effort will pick up the first and 10 for Mick Ratzlaff. And he got it because of his size, 6'5", 200 pounds. And he was able to fall forward and pick up the first down, the first and 10 for Hastings today. Tom Hampton making ultimately the tackle for the Ravens. 14-13 to go in the half. First down is made by Hastings at this point. Wide to the right side out for the Broncos goes McCaslin. Hand to the left side and a wing to the left side. They'll just go to the single setback, and a motion man will go to the right side. Is Fleischer, quarterback back, looks for Fleischer, has him. He's going to be hit and hit again for no gain. Fleischer, 6'4", 235. They have two of the biggest tight end and receiving tight end that you're going to find around. No gain on the play. Arthur Westbrook over there for Benedictine. I think you also had Bauer over there. No gain on the carry, second down and 10. Still from their own 47-yard line. Second and 10. Quarterback in the shotgun formation. Hastings has apparently decided to attempt to throw the ball against Benedictine and Bingman. Drops back, sets up, looks downfield. Pass is caught at the 40, and tackle made at the 35-yard line, but a great catch by Fleischer, who was absolutely wide open at the 40. He turned downfield and punished Kenny Rump, who made the tackle for the Ravens. 13:09 to play in the half, and now Hastings has found something that is working for them, putting the ball in the air.
13 yards.
First and 10 to the 30-yard line. Two consecutive passes to Wade Fleischer, one for no gain and one for good yardage. And it's at the Raven 35, best field position of the game. Again from the shotgun, Bingman, pass caught at the 31-yard line. And finally the tackle made by the Ravens, still at the 31, on Brad McCaslin. This is exactly what Baker did with success. Put the quarterback back in a shotgun formation and allow him to use his good athleticism and ability to either throw or run with the football to make those proper decisions and carry them out. Frank Goa will get the credit for the tackle for the Ravens. A gain of 5. At the 30-yard line, second down, 5. 12, 15 to play.
30-yard line.
Motion man to the right side is Barda. Receivers left and right, single set back in the backfield, and the pitcher will go to Whitten. He'll get to the corner. He's at the 30, turns to the 27-yard line, where Tommy Hampton is over there, along with Frank Goa and Joe McGuire. We're going to mark it just inside the 28th. We're going to the 27th. Third down and a long two. Ravens looking to make a great defensive stand here. It was not until this series that Benedictine has given up its first down of the game. And now the Broncos, feeling as though they've found something that's working for them, are staying with the shotgun. Bingman is back on a third down short. Motion man to the right side is Bartek. No one in the backfield with a quarterback. No one has stayed in the block. He's back. Look, man, wide open, complete. But is it enough for the first down? Whitten made the catch. Rump made the immediate tackle. And it is going to be a first down by about a length of a football. It was a great bit of running. Great bit of annoying by Gordon Whitten where the first down markers are. And that's a first and 10 for the Broncos. They are putting together a very impressive drive on this series. And they have it first and 10 just inside the Raven 25-yard line. And with the win at their back, this is probably something else they were waiting for in the first quarter before throwing the ball and going to the shotgun, is to get the win behind them. Staying with the gun. Two men in the backfield and two receivers to the right. Now a motion man to the right side is Whitten. Quarterback takes a snap. Back to throw. Johnson steps up, and the pass is, hits a lineman in the middle of the back. The pass hits big old Ryan Lucy, 6'10", 310-pound sophomore. He is in as the tackle on the right side, and it hit him. I mean, it's hard to miss a guy that size. 11:01 to go. The clock will stop for the incompleted pass. And the penalty marker lying on the turf, and the officials talk it over with Benedictine College's Greg Bauer. Greg says, let's push him back. We'll let him move downfield and make the call. It'll be holding against Hastings. We remind you that Hughes Place, your game and refreshment headquarters in Atchison, one of the sponsors of Benedictine College playoff football here on CARE. It's good to have you here this afternoon. Keep in mind, the Mar Hill Junior Ravens in their quest for the Class 4A state title will be on from Wichita in the pregame at about 4:40 this afternoon. Quarterback back to throw again. Bingman, penalty markers down. It's a procedure call. The pass is complete to Whitten in the backfield. He's at the 40 at the 35. But it's going to be another penalty against Hastings as we had a procedural call. Ken McGivney makes this tackle. Third quarter score. Westminster, Pennsylvania is going to make it a long bus ride home. They lead Prince 13-0 in Pennsylvania. Procedure call is going to be marked off against the Broncos, and this may be something the Ravens need. Again, the shotgun formation is working very well. Not only are they picking up good yardage, it's allowing them to be very economical with the clock. They've utilized a minimal amount of time at this point. Officials look over at the sticks. Bauer saying, no. The ball was around the 38-yard line. He's not only playing defense, but he's officiating the game as well. Very busy guy out there. And now they'll assess it and mark it down after the 5-yard penalty to the 44-yard line, where it will be a first down and 29 yards. First and 29.
First down, 29 for the Broncos.
The Broncos of Hastings College facing a first down very long and immediately go right back to the shotgun. Both backs are in, one behind each tackle. The snap is low, picking up off the ground by Bingman. He steps up. Intercepted by Bauer. And he slipped and fell at the 35, but it doesn't matter. Greg Bauer with an outstanding job of intercepting the football. No markers are down, and the Ravens hustle out on offense. The penalty marker, ultimately proved to be the downfall of Hastings on that series, as they had marched the ball and had come downfield in a hurry. 10:36 to go, and a big defensive play for the Ravens have the crowd on its feet here in Atchison this afternoon. An I formation will set up in the backfield for Tabor. Big man on the left side. The pitch to Brown. He needs a block. Will not get it. tackled by the headgear. No markers were called as Brown is hit and spun and swung to the ground. The big tackle is made by Ryan Fahey.
We all got it, Coach.
10:20 to go. Clock is winding. It'll be a loss of a yard on the carry by Don Brown. Back to the 34. Again, you've got to realize that the Hastings team is going to be king on Don Brown. It'd be crazy for him to do anything else. Wing man to the left side is DeAndra. Hand off Brown, sweeps to the left. He's in traffic. He will get the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Nowhere for Don Brown to go on that carry as he is hit, stood up, and Don Hewlett and Jerry Drake again over there to make the tackle. Jerry Drake. So, couple of pretty good defensive players already this season, but he may be the best we've spotted so far. 9.5 minutes to play in the half.
Look at the size of him right there. He is
absolutely impressive at 6'5 and 285. And I'm not so sure he's maybe not more like 6'6 or 6'7. Third down. And a dozen. The handoff again to Brown. He'll bust up the middle, cross the 35, and pick up a couple or three, but the Ravens will be punting the football into the wind this time. As Benedictine on three consecutive running plays in the hands of Don Brown were unable to capitalize and pick up a first and 10. And Hastings expects a poor kick from Nettles as they look at that flag out there and it's standing out pretty well. The return man for the Broncos, number 27, Steve Chandler, stands at his own 35. The snap is back, the kick is away. He played it about perfectly. He'll take it on a run at the 40 and be run out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Joe Widlowski powering him out of bounds into the Bronco bench across the way. It's a little odd for me to be standing up here and looking across the Benedictine bench and see so few guys out there. I believe 44 is the number of people that you can carry on your playoff roster, 48. And about half as many as we normally see on the sideline on a given Saturday for the Ravens. 8:37 to play in the half. Ravens lead at 7-0, and the Broncos back with the football, first and 10 at their own 45. Handoff, fullback hits the middle, picks up about 3 yards of a carry. It's Bill Barda. Very basic play, just simply took it up the middle, powers over the left side, and it's going to be tackled there by Randy Salzer.
Three of the tackle made by number 53, Randy Salzer.
Gain of about three. At their own 48-yard line, 2nd and 7. Continuing to roll in this first half. The first quarter moved along particularly slowly, it seemed, but now the second quarter has gained a little bit of tempo, a little bit of speed. These teams, I think, beginning to settle into their offense somewhat. Split backs in the backfield, and the quarterback is back to throw once again. Looks right, now left, has a man wide open, and it's off his fingertips and a penalty marker at the 50. Arthur Westbrook was a long way away from the intended receiver, Kent Sanders, but I think they're going to call an interference call because they were the only two guys anywhere near that penalty marker. We're going to have an offensive pass interference call against Ken Sanders, who pushed off of Arthur Westbrook and tried to come back to the football. That's the second offensive pass interference call we've seen in this ball game. One of them against Benedictine, 7:55 to go. Keep in mind, it's going to be a loss of down as well as a penalty yardage assessed. 7:55 to go in the half. Ravens will put out a couple of substitutions. Luke Brewster comes out for Benedictine along with Tim Selby as the Ravens will take out Goa and Burke. We're going to add a little more secondary coverage out there as the Ravens expect the ball to be put in the air. Third down and 22. 7:55 to play in the half. Ravens up 7-0. The Broncos will go from the shotgun. Bingman, what a nice job so far in the first half. Bauer at that middle linebacker spot directs a little traffic in the Raven defense, and the rush is on. Stepping up, the pass slipping is caught by Fleischer. He's done an outstanding job, and Bauer comes up to stand over him. Say what? Fleischer has got a little size on Greg Bauer. Bauer at 5'11", Fleischer is 6'4". And it's going to be fourth down in a punting situation. Mitch Eckhart in to kick the ball away. We'll stand at his own 23. And again, it'll be Rump and Brown for the Ravens. The snap of Corwin is taken on a bounce, and the kick away, and it is at Corwin. Wobbly, lands at the Raven 47. Takes a good Bronco bounce to the 45 and the 40, and finally down at the 36-yard line. So nonetheless, the important thing for the Ravens is they have gotten the football back with 7 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the half, and Benedictin leading it 7-0. Ravens will step back into the backfield and in Chris Tabor once again. Primary objective for this Benedictin front line, which has been just absolutely incredible all season long, is going to be keeping Jerry Drake's hands off of Chris Tabor for the rest of the day. Tabor steps up under center, trip to the right side. Corline, the single set back in the backfield, will take the handoff, hit the middle, hit a brick wall, and hit the ground after a gain of maybe a yard. And on the tackle, Alex Tuilosega. A gain of a yard, 2nd and 9. Now, under 7 minutes to play in the half. Quickly, again, staying with the huddle. Wide to the near side, Marcinowski. And the two men filling the slot will be Brown and Perez. Harbison is your tight end on the left side. Defense steps up as if to blitz. Quarterback is back to throw. Steps up, looks downfield, has Marcinowski, he's got it across the 45 at the 48-yard line. Tackled by Roger Perkins, and a great job again by Marcinowski of making that catch. Chris Marcinowski is coming to have an outstanding season this year for Benedictin, a freshman out of San Antonio. 1st and 10 for the Ravens at the 43-yard line. 6.5 minutes to go and winding in the half. Chips down to the left side, the wide side of the field, and a penalty mark for Sales before the ball can be put in play. Somebody find themselves, I think, in the neutral zone, perhaps. The official from the far side in front of the Hastings bench is one who dropped the marker and now comes to the center of the field to discuss it with his fellow officials. Wind has shifted just a little bit. It came at the beginning of the game out of the northwest. They're going to say inadvertent. They're going to pick this marker up. And the wind from the northwest has now shifted more northerly, even maybe just a little bit from the northeast at this point. They'll rewind the clock, pick up the marker, and the Ravens again, to reset this, will be facing a 1st and 10 at their own 48-yard line. All three men to the left side, Perez, Brown, and Marcinowski. Tore line in the backfield. We'll take the handoff. Bounce in the middle, hit the 50. That's all. Tore line can do no more than that as Pat Fisher and Roger Perkins again will bring him to the range of the can pair. Bringing clean, dry football in. The condition of the field was a concern of Larry Wilcox is coming into the game today. And so far, it's held up reasonably well. But you can see as Bauer intercepted the ball a moment ago, he slipped and fell. And as the game continues to progress, the field progresses to be worse. Fishers are going to come up over the ball again and stop play. And it's 2nd down at the midfield mark. I think this is really lack of communication here between the officials. And certainly, your postseason play, you want to do things absolutely correctly. And if it takes them another moment or two to do that, that's what they will do. 2nd down at the midfield mark for the Ravens. 2nd down, 8. Back to throw. Tabor sets up, fires a pass, has a man through the hands of Javier Perez. But Tabor's pass again rushed, and again it's Jerry Drake in the Benedictin backfield putting on some pressure along with Chris Holm. Clock stops at 5:26 to go in the half, and 3rd down now facing Benedictin College, 3rd down and 8. Ravens with it at the midfield stripe. Brown will be the tailback behind the four line. Receivers left and right. Tight end is on the left side. Quarterback hands off middle line. Absolutely nothing for Brown. He may even have lost a yard or two on the play, as it was a tremendous defensive play as the Ravens have gotten a little misdirection. But again, you've got Jerry Drake coming in to make a tackle for them. And the Ravens will be forced to kick it again. And into the wind, back deep for the Broncos is going to be Steve Chandler. Chandler unable to make a return on the last punt by Nettles. Nettles is standing in a soft portion of the field at his own 35. Takes the ball, advances on it, and gets away an end-over-end kick. Fair catch called for and made by the up man at the 30-yard line. It was taken there by Don Helt, a defensive cornerback 4 minutes and 47 seconds remain to be played in the first half of the ballgame here this afternoon. Benedictine. Two timeouts in the opening quarter they utilized. So far, Hastings still has their full complement remaining and may elect to use some of those on this series. They would like to come downfield and tie this thing up before going in at intermission. Bingman will bring him out of the huddle and come up over the football. Todd Athey, wide to the left side. Coming wide to the right side is Sailors. Again, the I formation in the backfield, Witten and Bartak. Sailors will be motion man to the right. Now we'll take it on the reverse. Cuts right. Bauer sees him. Bauer hits him and he doesn't make the tackle. Back at the near side of the 20 to the 25. Hit at the 30. Finally the 31-yard line. Tell you what, Sailors did a tremendous job of getting back to the line of scrimmage. There may have been a block in the back and back in the backfield, but Johnson came over with Westbrook to make the tackle for Benedict and Tommy. Hampton was in there, but Greg Bauer had diagnosed this play from the onset, but was not able to make a tackle on the elusive Ken Sailors. It'll be a second down and 10. And I suppose for Hastings, they're probably just saying, lucky to have gotten back to the line of scrimmage at all. Little deception was not successful for them in that instance, and Ratzlaff will go wide left. Again now in the shotgun formation. Hastings, Bingman, directing some traffic, says, Sailors, get over here to the near side. He's not where he wanted him to be, and Hastings is going to utilize a timeout. We will take a timeout with them right here. 3:53 to go in the half. The score, Benedictine 7, Hastings nothing.
Pretty.
You got,
Here's your phone number out here.
That's it, number one.
On the end, not in the middle.
Welcome back. Quarterback drops back, Bingman gets a pass away, and as it's complete, the ball is popped loose, and Hastings is going to recover it. Up at the 45-yard line, the pass was taken at the 40, turning upfield. Again, as big Wade Fleischer, he lost the ball as the Ravens hit him and drove him to the ground, but in a scramble for the football, the Broncos will come back up with it. And it'll be first and 10, Hastings at their own 45. Wade Fleischer is a great target to throw at. 6'4", 235, and you can really pick him out. First and 10, 3.5 minutes out of play in the half. Again from the gun, bringing to the near side in motion, Witten. Quarterback is back. Deep drop, in trouble, steps up, sets up a screen, and right through the hands of Barta, incomplete. And probably the fact that Grada and Johnson were bearing down on Roger Bingman had to make a difference in the accuracy of that throw. It stops the clock at 3:26. Second down. And again, back into the ballgame for Benedictine. They're going to bring Brewster and Selby as the Ravens shuttle in a couple of more defensive backs. 3:26. 7-0 Benedictine on top here in the late going of the first half. Staying with that shotgun. This time they got their three receivers to the short side of the field and one to the far or the wide side then. Quarterback is back to throw. He's looking for Fleischer. Got a little bump. The pass, Fleischer's got it at the Raven 40. Drags tacklers to the 35. Tacklers to the 30. Four guys are on him. He's down to the 26-yard line, and Fleischer will not be brought down. He was leapt upon and tackled, and a poor attempted tackle made by Tom Hampton. Hampton just thought he was going to be able to carry him down. There's no way that's going to happen. Hampton is 170 pounds, and there's no way he's going to drag Wade Fleischer down carrying him around the shoulder. First and 10, Broncos, 3:15 to go. And Hastings looks like a team that's going to tie things up, but Benedictine's not able to come up with a big defensive play. Last time down was a Bauer interception. Motion man to the near side, staying with that shotgun formation, Bingman. Ravens have not gotten to the quarterback yet. He's up, he passes, it's incomplete. The official may have blocked a little bit of the vision of the intended receiver on that play. It'll go incomplete, negative second down and 10. Brad McCaslin just couldn't quite hold on to the football. 2:56 now to go. Let me remind you, a couple of things. First of all, you're enjoying Benedictine football on KERE, Atchison, Kansas. And second of all, there's more football after this Raven game today. The junior Ravens will be on later this afternoon. Motion man to the right side and Sailors on a second down 10. Bingman back to throw, not only for the shotgun, but then he goes deeper. Yeah, pass over the middle, it's caught.
Yeah,
and then
yeah,
a tackle made.
Yeah.
And the ball's loose, and Benedict. Becton has come up with it. Coming up with it is Randy Salzer. He scored a touchdown last week by picking up a football. And now Salzer picks up the loose ball once again. The pass was complete. Tremendous hit was put on at that point by Benedictine. And then the ball popped loose. Salzer picks it up. And as I mentioned just a minute ago, first of all, last time down when the Ravens needed a big defensive play, it was Bauer picking up the interception. This time it's Salzer picking up the fumble with 2:50 to go in the half. And now the Ravens with an opportunity to tack on another score before intermission. 7-0, Ravens on top now. I left formation. DeAndrea in the backfield, a handoff, Brown, short, going maybe a yard, no more. Brown tries to go to the left side. On the near side, I'm looking down at the pass route, Chris Marcinowski covered man-to-man by Roger Perkins. They've got Perkins listed at 6'1". He towers over Chris Marcinowski. Chris is not that small at 5'11". But at a cutter, not going to the huddle. That will give Brown a yard to the 24. Second down, 9. 2:15 to play now in the half. Taper with a long count. Again, the handoff, same play, same result. They keep running Brown into the same hole, and Brown continues to pick up no yardage. The Ravens have to be setting something up here. They are going to run left and run left and continue to run left until something becomes open for them. And now the officials are going to stop the clock as we'll hold on here just a minute to see, did Hastings call a timeout, or are they just going to set the chains up? No timeout has been taken, I don't believe. Yes, it is. We do have a timeout taken, a very delayed call by the official here. We will take a timeout on the field. Timeout with 1:58 to go in the half, and the score, Benedictine 7, Hastings nothing. Benedictine, the pitch to Brown. He needs a block to get to the outside. He will get right and will be caught from behind. A nice job by Chris Cole of catching Brown at the 29-yard line with a little move there. Brown picks up big yardage. Hastings will use its final timeout, but we will not take it here as quickly. Coming back onto the field will be the Benedictine kicking team and the return team for Hastings. Now, here's going to be the situation for the Broncos. With 1:50 to play in the half, they're going to have to throw the ball virtually every down because I believe they have used the final timeout of the first half. They should get the ball in pretty good field position, all in all, as Nettles will stand around his 15-yard line to kick it away. And the return man, Steve Chandler, will stand at the Bronco 45 for the return. The short man in front of Chandler is going to be Don Helt, and he will stand at the Raven 48, 7 yards in front of the deep return man. Nettles takes the snap, very high, goes up and gets it and gets a kick away. Wobbly end over end, and it will come across the 50, and the Ravens will follow it down to the 47-yard line, where it will be downed by Benedictine's Dan Moore. And it'll be first and 10. They're going to say it's a 49. They're going to move it back out to the 49. First and 10 for Hastings with 1:43 to go. And they are 51 yards away from the end zone with a wind at their back. And they will throw probably virtually every play. Again, I've talked about the fans. A great group of Hastings fans have come out for the game. Coming wide to the right side is Ken Saylor. Says Roger Pinkman, the freshman quarterback, steps up behind center. Split backs behind him, receivers left and right. Long count, quarterback, short drop. Timing pass, didn't have the man, now fires one over the middle. It's tipped again, and intercepted by Arthur Westbrook. It was tipped by Bauer and then by Goa, and finally Westbrook had a diving chance and it couldn't pick it off. Wade Fleischer, the intended receiver. Maybe, but more than even Fleischer's size that impresses me is his speed. He gets downfield in a hurry for a guy at 6'4", 235. Good agility and really fine hands for that big tight end. Again, the Ravens will send in a couple of extra defensive backs. They're playing a three-down lineman defense. Quarterback is back. Lots of time. Pass over the middle, and it is incomplete. And Fleischer leaping into the air, covered man for man by Tim Selby. And again, all of those Ravens in the secondary giving up a lot of size to Wade Fleischer. And he did a pretty good job of getting in the air in an attempt at pulling down the football. Maybe Bigman having a problem in the second quarter, not unlike what Tabor had in the first. The wind at his back, making that football carry on him a little bit. The wind, though, I think maybe somewhat less pronounced at this point in the ball game, as we are a minute 29 away from halftime. It's still 7-0 Benedictine. Third down, 10 from their own 49-yard line for Hastings. The snap is poor, but picked up nicely by Bingman. He sets up with time over the middle. It's batted, and is it picked off? No. Again, three Ravens get a hand on the football. This time, the first man to bat it was Ken McGivney. And the Ravens will put their punt return team on the field. And again, this Benedictine defense, looking for a shutout in the first half, has done a fantastic job here today. Romp and Brown will settle into the 15-yard line. The snap is back. It's a good one, and the boot is away. It's wobbling, angling to the other side. Romp takes it over the shoulder of the 25, and he is hit at the 26. Ken Romp, misjudging the carry of that football, had to leap in the air and kind of take it over his shoulder at the 25-yard line. And by the time he was able to recover, the kick coverage was down there with him, a return of about a yard, and with a minute 12 to go. And the Ravens, having one timeout left, the question becomes, will they attempt to score, or are they going to just wind it out here in the half? I just can't imagine them winding it out. It's not like them to do that. Coming wide to the near side. Sorry, let me trade back. Coming wide to the near side is Marcinowski and Brown. Tour line in the backfield. Takes the handoff on the draw play, bounces left, gets nothing. The tackle for Hastings by Gerald Hunt. No gain on that play for Steve Torline. It was a well-conceived play, but Hunt doing a very alert job of watching the football, knowing where it was at all times, and we're now down to 50 seconds to play in the half. Perez to the near side and Marcinowski to the far side. Tabor looks left and right as he calls the audible. Harbison is a tight end on the right. Brown now will fill a slot to the wide side. Quarterback is back to throw. Rolls right, in trouble. Let's lose the pass, it is incomplete. Brown had not fully run his route, had not turned back to look for the football, and it lands harmlessly on the ground with a half a minute to play in the half. And it's not impossible at this point now for Hastings to get their hands back on the football. 30 seconds to play. May just be a reason that the Ravens elect to run the ball here on third down in a dozen, as opposed to throwing it. Benedictine is moving into the wind also in the second quarter, and it's been a factor in this game to this point. Ball inside the 25-yard line. Just inside the 24, in fact, on the third down 12. Half a minute to play in the first half. Tabor steps up with a single man behind him. Again, two to the left and one to the right. Hand off the same play, the draw play. Tour line, nothing doing. Maybe a yard up to the 25, and that is it, as he's tackled by Pat Fisher. And Benedictine, I am sure, is just going to allow this clock to wind down and take it to the locker room at halftime. No timeouts left for Hastings. They have no way of stopping it to get their hands on the ball once again. And the Ravens allowing it to get down now at 5 seconds. They're just standing and waiting for it to end. And we've come to halftime here at Amelia Earhart Stadium in Atchison, Kansas. I'll be back to wrap it up for you from the first half with the score at intermission. Benedictine 7, Hastings nothing. And two men back deep on the return for the Broncos. We're set to go to the second half from Atchison, Kansas. The kick is away and it'll be taken by Chandler. He's at the 10-yard line, at the 20. He's submarined and driven to the ground, and the football pops loose. Arthur Westbrook, I think, is a man who got in there. It is Arthur, who absolutely took the pegs from beneath Steve Chandler. And it'll be first and 10 for Hastings College. And we'll see where they're going to spot it down at. Just outside the 20. We call it the 21-yard line. You can hear the groan here in the press box. It was a tremendous individual tackle by Arthur Westbrook. Okay, if I'm Dane Kretzer and I'm at halftime talking to my Hastings team, I'm telling them, guys, patience. This is a good football team we're playing against. We're within one score. No reason to panic yet. And, oh yes, throw it a lot. Quarterback makes a pitch, sweeping to the outside, turning up field and picking up a couple of yards to be Gordon Witten. He'll go up to about the 24-yard line, giving him credit for about three on that carry before he was spun down by Greg Bauer. And right now, Hastings is getting into the most slippery portion of the field, the field where the turf conditions are the poorest and where the footing is going to be the most difficult to come by.
Yeah.
Second down and seven from the 24-yard line. Hastings on their own end of the field. Again, Bingman will step up under center. He has Witten and Bart in the backfield for him. Receivers also to the left and right. Draw play, hand off to Witten. He's going to be hit and drugged down from behind by Kenny McGivney. There will be no gain on the play. And it'll depend on the spot of the football, maybe even a loss of about a half a yard or so. Third down and still seven for Hastings. Roger Bingman, 6'2", 205-pound freshman quarterback, has been impressive during the course of the season and continues to be impressive here this afternoon, coming into the game with over 2,100 yards passing and has thrown for 9 touchdowns a season. And with that in mind, he's back to throw from the shotgun formation on a third down 7. The football at their own 24-yard line. Bingman's back to throw, looks left, gets a man out of the backfield as Barda. He's going to be at the 25, and he's going to be hit and driven down at the 26-yard line. Bill Barta will pick up 2 or 3 yards, but it's going to be well short of the first down marker. And a penalty marker again on the field. So we will begin the second quarter, much in the fashion we played the first, with an infraction, personal foul against Benedictine on the late hit. So the Ravens shoot themselves in the foot here in the beginning of the second half. They had stopped the ball carrier, Bill Barta, for what was going to be something 5 yards, close to 5 yards short of the first down, and instead it's going to be first down with 10 to spare. First and 10. Broncos. The football will be put to rest at the Hastings 41. 13:25 to go in the third quarter. 7-0 Benedictine College on top. Hastings, having taken the opening kickoff to begin the second half, is now moving the football downfield. Kent Salyers will go to the left side. Now he will come in motion to the right. Again, the split backs in the backfield for Bingman, who is back to throw. Sets up. No rush. Fires a pass over to Salyers. He will take it on the left side. Will try to get around the corner, but can't do it. Bauer and go and make a tackle for the Ravens after a gain of about 3. As a matter of fact, they're going to be less generous than that. Make it a gain of 2, second down and 8 for Hastings College. Kent Salyers, a 5'9 senior. We've got him in the program at about 170 pounds from Chicago, Illinois. Gain of a pair, second down, 8. Hastings, again, moving the football on the first possession of the second half. Split backs for Bingman. Motion man is McCaslin now to the right side. Quarterback is back to throw. McCaslin is open over the middle. Quarterback's open to throw. Finally gets a pass away. Delayed and intended for Barta. But it is going to be incomplete. Barta hit and spun down by Joe McGuire. The pass incomplete, having fallen to the ground around midfield. And again, Bingman, there was a little confusion, I think. He had two receivers right together and right between him was an official. And I think Bingman believed, had he thrown the ball into that vicinity, it could easily have been picked off or intercepted because there would have been some confusion as to the intended receiver of the ball. So he picked out a different receiver, it fell incomplete, and it's now third down and 8. From the gun, receivers left and right. A back stays in the block. Now he will release and look for the safety valve. The pass is over there to him. Barta has it. Misses the tackle to the 50 and just short of the first down. The tackle by Bauer. The initial tackle missed by McGuire. As it was a good move by Barta after catching the football to shake the defender, move it downfield to the 50. And you can hear in the background the Bronco fans. They say, we want to go for it on 4th and 1 at the midfield stripe. And that very well may be what Coach Kratzer elects to do here. And that would be telling you a lot. First series of the second half, you're at the 50, and you're going to go for it on 4th down, trailing in the ball game. It's apparent that Hastings doesn't feel like they're going to want to give the Ravens any opportunities. A handoff in the middle. The man is hit and then lunges forward. Great second effort for the first down. Bill Barta was hit and then was able to turn his body sideways and knife forward to pick up a first down. First and a 10 for the Hastings Broncos. The clock stops as they advance the chains. Ken McGivney ultimately makes the tackle for the Ravens. for the chains will be moved with 11 and a half minutes to play. We're in the third quarter. Bigman at the Raven 48 is back to throw. Sets up, looks left, looks right. Little flare pass over the middle is incomplete and a penalty marker. Probably a hold in the center. We'll get the call from the official holding against Hastings. What's happening here is Roger Bingman is getting a world of time to throw the football. He looks downfield. He has no one open, and so he is still able to pick out his, after his second and maybe even third, he's able to pick up a fourth receiver, get the ball to him. He may be short, but at that point there's broken field for usually Barter or Whitten, somebody coming out of the backfield. A little room for them to run and maneuver. In this instance, though, the holding penalty is going to cost Hastings all the way back to their own 35-yard line. Again, that penalty being assessed from the point of infraction, it will bring up a first and 26. First down and 26 yards to go with 11:17 to go in the third quarter. 7-0 Benedictine College leading, a score they made back in the opening quarter. Offense is warming up down here in front of us. Benedictine just, I think, aching to get their offense out on the field for the second half. From the shotgun, Bingman. Both backs in. Now they will both drop out. Little flare pass on the left side to Whitten. He's got room at the 40, 45. He's hit and dropped down at the 50-yard line. Hit by Bauer, I believe, initially from behind. And then ultimately drugged down. Ken Romp is over there also. Arthur Westbrook as well. We'll get it back around the original line of scrimmage in Raven territory about the 49, second and 11. Good run that time after the catch of the football. Gordon Whitten has already run for over 1,200 yards coming into the game here today. Second down, 11 from the Benedictine 49-yard line. Staying with the shotgun formation are the Broncos. Both backs stand. The snap is a little high, but Bingman's able to pick it up. The screen is set up. It's taken at the 50-yard line by Salyer. He's going to be hit. He is not going to get to the outside as Joe McGuire brings him down. As a matter of fact, Salyer, trying to get to the outside, had given up a little yardage and ultimately lost a couple of yards on the carry. Matter of fact, they're going to call it a loss of four back to the 47. 10 minutes to play in the third quarter. An impressive, time-consuming kind of possession for the Broncos, as they have had the football for the entire second half, so they're already over 5 minutes on this possession and still are short of midfield. It's third down, 14. Motion man to the left side. Quarterback from the shotgun is back to throw. Loads of time. Lots of time. Sets up, fires a pass. It's caught, and they're going to say he slipped and his knee touches the ground at the 46. The ball was caught by Todd at the 46-yard line, and he was hit by McGivney. His knee bumps the ground, and very quickly, the Broncos are in to punt it away to Brown and Romp. The Raven return men at the Benedictine 15. The kick is away in a big rush. It is high and short, and it will take a good Bronco bounce from the 25 to the 20-yard line. So Benedictine will begin its first possession of the second half, first and 10, at the Raven 20-yard line. Pizza Hut, one of the sponsors of Benedictine College playoff football, for delivery call 367-7440. 9:28 to play in the third quarter. Over 5.5 minutes utilized by Hastings in that first series of the second half. Single set back in the backfield for Chris Tabor. Now they will swing Bill Harbison to the tight end on the left. Handoff, Torline, hits the middle, breaks across the 20 to the 23-yard line, where he is going to be strung out, and the tackle made by Matt Pawlowski. Second down. They're going to mark him up just about the 24-yard line, so it'll be second down, 6. Back to the I formation now for Tabor and the Raven offense. They have Marcinowski to the right, Perez to the left. Quarterback slides down the line, keeps it himself, cuts upfield, nowhere to go. And Tabor is absolutely pummeled, and there comes a flag. Tabor was hit by one or two. It had the head and face gear driven into the ground. They continue to get on him, and Jason Main will get credit for the tackle. Tabor's going to have to shed the helmet in order to peel the turf from it. And the officials will talk it over, and I assume they're going to assess a late hit penalty. 8:50 to go in the third quarter.
Yeah,
we're going to take a little time and talk it over.
A
couple of other things to talk to you about. I'll remind you again, one of the sponsors, Seaman & Schuschke Metalworks Company, handling any sheet metal or roofing job. And the face mask penalty against Hastings will be a first down. It is an incidental face mask, only a 5-yard variety. I don't know if you could call them celebrities, but we have a lot of interesting people who have come to the ball game this afternoon. Past Raven football athletes, they include Keith Hertling, the young man who, with 1,542 yards in a season, had the Raven rushing mark for some 17 years. He's not old enough for that. I'm not old enough for that. The handoff, Corline, in the middle of the 30. Corline's at the 35. He's to the 40. To the 42-yard line. Steve Torline finally dragged down by strong safety Gary Freeman. But he picks up another Benedictine first down.
12-yard gain for Torline.
Nice carry by Torline. Wouldn't be surprised to see some more Torlines in the crowd if we were to look around. Also, Jamie Mueller, Benedictine's single game rushing leader in the crowd here today. Single setback. Brown will now come in motion to the near side. First and 10, Benedictine at the 42. Hand off to Orline again. He's at the 45, 46, near the 47-yard line. But once again, you've got Freeman in on the tackle for Hastings. Joining him in the middle of the stack, big number 70, Ryan Fahey, 6'2", 240 pounds, defensive lineman. Big and strong. 7:45 to go in the third quarter. 7-0 Benedictine and the Ravens with our first possession of the second half. They began at their 20. Now they're moving it upfield. They have it second down at about 5 at their own 47. From the eye, the handoff to Brown. Needs some blocking. Gets to the 50. He's at the 45, 40. Brown's going to go at the 35. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. He's at the 5. Touchdown! Don Brown, 10 to the right side. Looked as though he might have been stopped at the line of scrimmage, broke away, and in a foot race to the end zone, won it. 53-yard touchdown ramble for the Ravens with 7:27 to go in the third quarter. And Don Brown has played in the shadow of these two guys we've talked about out here in the stands for the entire season, but he is really, really making some sunlight of his own here today. Extra point attempt by Gormley as the hands outstretched by Bill Nettle.
How many yards? 53.
They await the snap. The ball is down. The kick is airborne. It's good. We've got a timeout on the field. 7:27 to play in the third quarter of the ball game. It's now Benedictine College 14, Hastings nothing. The kick is away by Gormley. It is high. It's end over end, and it's going to be taken at the 5-yard line. Hastings brings it back up to the 15 to 20, and at the 25-yard line, the tackle is made by the Ravens kick coverage team. The return was by Hastings, number 28, Matt Saka. A sophomore from Roscoe, New York. Kenny Rump and Jeff Grotta downfield for Benedictine on the coverage. An absolutely spectacular 53-yard touchdown run on that play a moment ago by Don Brown to give the Ravens a 14-point advantage. Coming off the sideline now is Roger Bingman, the freshman quarterback for Hastings College. He's got his work cut out for him here a little bit. He's going to need to put the ball in the air. Athey to the left side. Salyers to the right. Split back to the backfield for Bingman. The pitch. Sweeping to the side is Witten. He'll put his head down. He's going to be hit at the line of scrimmage for no gain. Bauer coming off the stack. Goa also over there for the Ravens. What a downfield block was put on, and Arthur Westbrook is down. We are going to take a timeout on the field here, an injury timeout, as one of the Ravens will be attended to. With 7:08 to play in the third quarter, timeout on the field and the score. Benedictine 14, Hastings nothing. To his own power, and it's going to be second down 9. The handoff into the right side of the line. Good running by Witten as he's going to go across the original line, the 25, up to the 30 and down at the 32-yard line by Selby and Hampton. Tim Selby coming into the ball game to replace Arthur Westbrook, who has come over and he's being attended to on the near sideline, but he's working the arm and the shoulder, and he says, right now, I want to go back into the game immediately. 6:35 and winding in the third quarter of the ball game. Brinkman will bring them up to the line of scrimmage at their own 32-yard line. Hastings has a football, third down, 4. Split back behind him again, and the pitch. Sweeping to the left side. The first down, spinning is good. And more at the 40 to the 45-yard line. Winton, a great run. As he turned the body sideways, Hampton making the tackle for the Ravens with Romp. But it's an outstanding run by Gordon Witt, cutting to the left side and picking up a first and 10 for Hastings. Arthur Westbrook back in the ballgame for Benedictine, and Tim Selby checks out. The wind picking up a little bit again, and it subsided somewhat at one point in the late going of the half, but it is again very brisk. They've got everybody up on the line of scrimmage, no wide receivers out in this situation. Bingman, first and 10. Hand off again to Whitten. He'll again take it to the left side, and we'll pick up a couple 3 yards to the 47. Give him 2 yards on the carry to the 47-yard line, where Chris Johnson makes the tackle for the Ravens. And by running the ball into the middle, it's actually running at the strength of the Benedictine defense, running it into the middle of that line. And again, you have to suppose that Coach Kratzer is doing this very knowingly with his eyes wide open, because he's got to be looking to be putting something together, be setting up a play. This time in the full house backfield, they'll have the wingman to the right side. And again, the handoff this time, they'll drive right. McGivney making a tackle on Whitten as he crosses the midfield mark and goes into Benedictine territory at the 49. It'll be a gain of about 3 more yards for Hastings College. And now they're looking to maybe try to grind it out a little bit. And there's no better way to set up the pass than by running the ball into the middle between the tackles. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. 14-0 Benedictine College, but again, Hastings moving the football, and they've shown an ability to move the ball all during this game. Two of their two best drives, as a matter of fact, stopped by turnovers, one on a fumble and one on an interception. The handoff into the middle of the line to the 45, powering ahead. First down for Hastings to the Raven 44-yard line. Ken Romp and Ken McGivney making a tackle on Gordon Whitten. And the 5'11", 210-pound senior running back who has led this Bronco ball club in rushing all season long is beginning to establish himself here in the late going of the third quarter. Again, Whitten, over 125 yards per game rushing, 1,200 yards a season. To the shotgun on a first and 10. The Broncos mixing it up a little bit. We'll send Sam Myers, a motion man, to the left side, and quarterback is back to throw. Sets up, short pass complete at the 41. And tackle at the 40-yard line. The tackle immediately made there by Benedictine College as quickly as the ball was caught. The pass to Whitten. Frank Goa made the tackle on him. So not only is Gordon Whitten being utilized as the primary running back out of the backfield, but also as a receiver on that pass play. A gain of 4, second down and a half dozen at the Benedictine 40-yard line for Hastings. And they are moving the football this series. Again, both ends continue to remain in tight. Hand off Whitten. He's at the 40 to the 37 to the 36. The ball pops loose. Benedictine says they have picked it up. But the officials, I think, are going to say the football was down. And the Ravens unable to take it away that time. Instead, we'll be looking at third down and about 4. Joe McGuire making a tackle for the Ravens. Taking a big tight end out of the ball game. Chad Evans, 6'3". Got him down to 6'3 and 205, and again, looking bigger than that to me at this range. Third down and 4. Two backs in the backfield, a wingman to the right side, two tight ends, and the officials will stop play for just a moment and step up over the football. They want a clean, fresh football brought in from the far side. Bushmites, your Century Hardware distributor, a sponsor of Raven Playoff Football on Care Radio. The situation is third down and 4. The football at the Benedictine 37-yard line. Motion man to the left side now is Myers. Whitten, the single set back, and the quarterback, Bingman, is back to throw. He looks, he sets up, he's hit as he throws the ball. It's intercepted and dropped. It hit Arthur Westbrook between the 2 and the 5, and he couldn't hold on at the 18-yard line. The pass intended downfield for Mick Ratzlaff, 6'5" receiver. And Chris Johnson got to Roger Bingman just after he released the football. So again, the Ravens unable to put enough pressure on the quarterback, and Benedictine will send in the punt return team. The snap is back, the kick is away, and the Ravens don't send anyone deep. It will bound at the 12, and it will die at the 14-yard line. Took a very small Benedictine bounce, and the Ravens are going to be pinned well deep in their end of the field with 2:53 to go in the third quarter. From their own 14-yard line, first and 10, Benedictine College. Ravens will have with this last 2:53 of the third quarter the wind at their back, but then it will be the ally of the Broncos in the fourth period. It's going to be very important, as much as Hastings can and will throw the ball in the fourth quarter. Benedictine huddling it up at the 5. Now they'll break it and step out over the football. Sending wide to the right side, Chris Marcinowski. Brown and Perez to the left side. Perez now motion man to the right. The handoff, Torline. He hits the line, lunges forward across the 15 to maybe the 17-yard line. He is tackled about the ankles. Gary Freeman. It'll be a gain of about 4. Make it 3. Second down, 7. 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. The winner of this ball game will get 1 week off and will be playing December the 5th. Second down. Again with a single set back behind him. Tabor taking a long time now as the Ravens becoming somewhat more patient. They'll bring Harbison into the tight end on the left side. And that will bring Brown now in motion to the right. Quarterback is back to throw. In trouble. The pass is incomplete. Thrown short of the intended receiver. And again, Jerry Drake absolutely put the hurt on Chris Tabor. The pass was intended for Marcinowski, but it goes incomplete. And for the Ravens now, it's third down and long. Third down and about 7. The incompletion stops the clock as well with 2:08 to go in the third quarter. 14-0, Benedictine College on top in this NAIA Division II first-round playoff football game. With the I formation now in the backfield, the Ravens will have a tight end on the left side and a motion man to the right. Play action, quarterback keeps it. Makes a late pitch to Brown at the 15. He'll go out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Hit there and bumped out of bounds by Doug Herbeck. And it will be well short of the first down. The Ravens will face a 4th-and-3. And once again, in will come the punting unit for Benedictine College. Hastings has had an opportunity several times. They have shown an ability to move the football very well during the course of this game. And they look to get it back in pretty good field position. The return man for Hastings is not even back beyond the midfield arc. Now he'll take a step back. Steve Chandler has shown explosive return talent. The kick is away. It is high. It gets into the wind. Chandler will chase it and take it at the 41 and be hit and say he slipped out of bounds at the 42. Ravens with pretty good coverage downfield. You had Salzer downfield for Benedictine on the coverage. Brandenburg also downfield for the Ravens. First and 10 Broncos, and they still come out of this with good field position. First and 10 at their own 42-yard line. Under 2 minutes now to play in the third quarter. 14-0, Benedictine on top. Bingman will bring them out of the huddle and step up over the football. He has got in the backfield Whitten and Myers. Whitten has become the workhorse for this club in the second half, and will take this handoff here. Hits the middle of the line, goes to the 45, maybe the 46-yard line. Big hole opened up in the middle of the line that time by the offensive blocking for Hastings. You've got Bauer in on the tackle for Benedictine along with Salzer. You can also see Joe Burke coming off the stack for the Ravens. It'll be at the 46-yard line, 2nd-and-6. Under 1.5 minutes now to go in the third quarter. Hastings will send Ratzlaff to the left side and Salyers to the right. Split backs and a long count. Quarterback Bingman back to throw. Fires a pass. It's caught and a flea flicker at the 50, at the 45, and bumped out of bounds at the 41. A little hook and ladder play as a pass was taken by Matt Ratzlaff. And then as he is skirted to the outside, he just shoveled it to Gordon Whitten, a little lateral, and Whitten turns the corner and picks up the 1st down for Dan Kratzer and the Hastings Broncos. Very creative play And again, if you don't win the game, there's no need in saving it for next year because it's all over. So you pull them out here today. We're going to see more of this in the fourth quarter. The lights coming on now a little bit at Amelia Earhart Stadium. First and 10 at the Benedictine 41-yard line. From the shotgun formation, Hastings moving the ball. The snap is back. The quarterback looking to the near side. A wide open Mick Ratzlaff had the ball thrown well away from him and pursuit against the quarterback by Jeff Garada. Bingman that time was looking into the eyes of Jeff Garada. Caused him to throw the ball somewhat errantly, and it goes incomplete, leaving a second down and 10. Still at the Benedictine 41-yard line. A minute six to go in the third quarter. A lot of time being taken here by Hastings. They're having a great deal of patience as they huddle up at midfield. From the Raven 41-yard line, again in the shotgun at second down 10. Motion man to the left side is Salyers. Quarterback takes the snap. He's back to throw. Looks downfield. Over the middle, it is batted and incomplete. Bauer tipped it in the air, intended for Wade Fleischer, and then immediately McGibney makes a hit on Fleischer as the ball goes by, but it is incomplete. It will bring up now a third down and 10, and I'm constantly impressed with the ability of Wade Fleischer, not only just because he's big, but because he's able to run so well to get downfield, to be open, and he's got good hands. So he's just an outstanding athlete. 6'4", 235, and a senior. One of the few seniors on this Hastings club. From the shotgun, again, third down and 10, the quarterback is back to throw. McGuire steps up on a safety blitz and does not make the tackle. The pass is away and is it caught? A diving catch by Fleischer, but he's short of the first down. Will Hastings go for it on fourth down here? They went for it at the 50-yard line on fourth and one. Will they go for it at the 32 on fourth and two? Or from the 32 on fourth, they're gonna mark it at the 33. I thought maybe the 32-yard line. They're at the 33, and they will go for it. On the 33-yard line, it is fourth down and two. The lights ever more in evidence. The handoff to the outside, following his blocking, and pushing forward is Gordon Whitten, and it looks as though he's picked it up. It's going to be first and 10 for Hastings, as again on fourth down, they're successful, and they may get one more playoff in this quarter. Again. Coach Kratzer gambling on it on fourth down, and again, when he rolls the dice, he comes out a winner from the Benedictine 29-yard line. Now, it is first and 10. Hastings hustles up over the football. Quarterback, hands off, Whitten, right side, powers forward, again following the big surge of blocking to the 27, and that's going to be the final play of the third quarter. We've got a timeout on the field from Amelia Earhart Stadium in Atchison, Kansas. After three quarters of play, the score, Benedictine 14, Hastings nothing. Down for Hastings, second and about seven. Football at the Benedictine 27-yard line. Shotgun formation. Bingman looking to the left side, and it is caught in the backfield to the 25-yard line. Taken by Sam Myers, tackled by Greg Bauer. They'll move the ball to the 25-yard line. Third down and five. And well, as we all know at this point, we're in four down territory for the Hastings Broncos, as they have gone twice already successfully on fourth down. Third down and five at the 25-yard line. 14 and a half minutes to play in this ball game. 14 and a half minutes before the end of the season for one of these two football teams today. Receivers left and right. Bingman is up under center with both backs in the backfield. He will make the pitch. Bingman, the ball's loose in the backfield. Now picked up. It's a halfback pass, and he just throws it. And the Ravens looking for an interception and can't pick it off as the pass was downfield for Brad McCaslin. The pitch from Bingman to Whitten. Whitten lost it, picked it up, ran back, and simply threw it toward the goal line. Hampton and Rump, each with an opportunity, stepping in front of McCaslin, but McCaslin at 6'3 and 210 was able to basically strip the ball away from the both of them, and it fell harmlessly incomplete, and now it's fourth down five. Fourth and five, a much different and much more difficult call in these fourth and ones, fourth and twos, where you can depend on your strength and the quality of running backs to pick you up a couple of yards. We may see Hastings put the ball in the air. On fourth down and two, they are going to go to the shotgun formation. Fourth down, rather, and five at the Benedictine 25. From the gun, Quarterback Bingman is back to throw. Steps up, thinking about running. Pass over the middle is caught and short. He is short of the first down marker. It'll depend on the spot of the football. It was a great catch by Myers, but he did not pick it up. It's Raven football at the 21. That was an outstanding tackle for Benedictine College on the play. The tackle will hold them short of the first down. And a tackle by Greg Bauer. Once again, the big senior comes up to make an outstanding defensive play. And it's two series that you can almost give him credit for having stopped this fourth down tackle and then the interception in the first half of the game. 14:01 to go in the contest, and the Ravens will put their offense back on the field, first and 10 at their own 21-yard line. Caver, single man behind him, hands off to Torline. He hits the middle, is hit several times, does a great job of just holding on to the football, and maybe got a yard. Certainly no more than that, if that much. Ravens running again into the left side of the offensive line, the right defensive side. Jerry Drake again making a tackle. We're going to have to start thinking of offensive and defensive players of the game before too long. 13.5 minutes to go. Second down. Quarterback is back to throw. Play action. Beautifully faked out everybody. Looks downfield. Javier is wide open. He's got it at the 30. To the 35-yard line. First and 10, Benedictine College. Javier Perez makes the catch. And the Ravens pick up a first down. And I tell you what, Chris Tabor completely fooled the rush of Hastings as he faked the handoff on the play action to the right side. Everybody followed him. He followed on to the left side to pick out his receiver. It's first and 10, Ravens at the 35. They're back to the line of scrimmage with trips to the right side. Torline in the backfield. Stepping up under center, Tabor. Motion man is Brown. He'll go to the left side, which is the short side of the field, and the quarterback is back. He's looking downfield. Wants Marcinowski. He's going to run. No, he's going to throw. He's got Perez at the 45-40. Perez at the 35. Javier at the 28-yard line. I thought maybe the quarterback across the line of scrimmage before releasing the ball, Pat Fisher, made the tackle, but an over-the-shoulder catch, full stride, Javier Perez, and it's first and 10, Benedictine College, the Ravens, at the 29-yard line. 36-yard pass play, and the Ravens move it well into Bronco territory, 12:55 to go. Ravens now are going to the huddle. They're taking a little more time off the clock. Three receivers now to the left side. Perez, Marcinowski, and Brown. Torline stays in the backfield. Tight end is Harbison. He's on the left. I'd like to see him catch one today just for the heck of it. Hand off Torline in the middle. Works for a couple of very difficult yards down to the 27-yard line. Matt Palowski makes the tackle along with Gerald Hunt. And right in front of Steve Torline, Mike Mossy. We can't talk enough maybe about this Raven offensive line, the kind of work they have done, the kind of job they have performed. You've got coming out of the ball game for a moment for Benedictine, John Angelo. You take out a 300-pound lineman, it's hard to replace him unless you've got somebody like Mike Spohr, another 300-pound lineman to put right back in again. Second down, 8, Benedictine at the 26-yard line. Quarterback keeps it to the left side. Bootleg at the 25. He's at the 20. Tabor's at the 15-yard line. First and 10, Ravens. Tabor, again, almost looked like play action. He faked the ball into the middle of Torline, pulled it back out, rolled out to the left side, then just tucked it under, went downfield, and again, Palowski will make a tackle. First and 10, Ravens at the 15-yard line. 11:53 to play in the ball game. The Ravens lead it 14-0. Two men to the right side and an I formation again behind Chris Tabor. This time you've got Harbison as a tight end on the right side, which is the wide side of the field on this particular down. Quarterback, hands off, Torline hits the middle, follows his blocking again for about two more yards. Steve Torline picking up the tough yardage in the middle of the fray, right behind Mike Spohr. Tackled in the middle by Gerald Hunt. There's another young player, freshman Gerald Hunt, doing a good job for Hastings in the defensive unit.
Gain of 2 for Torline.
We're approaching 11 minutes to play. Still a lot of football to be played here this afternoon, but Benedictine, if they are able to culminate this drive with a score, is going to make it very difficult for the Broncos. Single man to the backfield again. Two to the right and one to the left for Tabor. Four down linemen for the defense. The handoff to Brown as he cuts to the right side. He is dropped at the line of scrimmage. He is hit hard, and first, Jerry Drake hits him, and then he's finally polished off by Ryan Fahey. But Jerry Drake once again with a great tackle. Third down for the Ravens from the 13-yard line. It's third down 8. 10.5 minutes to play. Back to the standard I formation. We'll shift Benedictine College. Two receivers to the right side. Tabor with a long count. Play action, rolls right. He's going to run. He's at the 15-10. He's looking to the 5. First and goal, Benedictine at the 4-yard line. Tabor with the same play a moment ago to the left as Chris Pohl makes this tackle. This time the same play only to the right side. However, I believe that in my heart this was intended to be a passing play. It just developed in front of him, and the senior quarterback, with the knowledge to realize it and recognize it, moves the ball downfield in the Ravens. First and goal at the 4-yard line. Now you've got the big line, the big offensive line checks in for Benedictine. At a tight end, you've got Harbison, a little guy at 296. On the other side, you've got Jesper Johansson in the game for Benedictine. He at 296. First and goal, the handoff, Torline. He will not get much, a yard maybe, as he tries the right side of the line. It'll bring up a second and goal inside the 5. Put it still at the 4-yard line. No gain on the play. And once more, Pawlowski makes the stop for Hastings. This Hastings defense has been tough against the rush absolutely all season long. And it's going to be a chore for the Ravens to punch it in here. Second and goal at the 4. The number one ranked defense in the nation against the rush with a goal line stand right here. 9:25 to go in the game. And the Ravens up by 2 touchdowns. Tabor with signals. Hands off to Torline, nothing. Absolutely nowhere to go, and again, it's Jerry Drake making the tackle for the Broncos, and it's just a mass of white jerseys on top of Steve Torline. It's now third and goal. Matter of fact, maybe even the loss of yard from the 5-yard line now. Will the Ravens throw the ball into the flat? Will they go for a field goal if they don't pick up a touchdown? Interesting questions that only Larry Wilcox can answer right now. Third and goal at the 5-yard line. I formation, both ends in tight. DeAndrea, wing on the left side. Quarterback keeps it, rolls right, looks to throw. He's hit and just throws it into the ground. Incomplete. Hit first by Roger Perkins. Then immediately in behind Perkins was Matt Pawlowski. Fourth down and into the game for the Ravens. Welcome Mark Gormley and the Benedictine field goal unit. It's going to be a little more than an extra point range, but into a very brisk wind with 8:36 to play in the football game. Nettles will hold, and the Ravens will spot it at the 17. Let's make it the 18, a 28-yard field goal attempt. Hands outstretched by Bill Nettles. He waits the snap from center. It's down. The kick is up. The kick is good. We'll take a timeout on the field with 8:36 to play in the game. It's now Benedictine 17, Hastings nothing. The kick is away by Benedictine. It's going to be taken by an up man at the 30-yard line, at the 35, at the 40. A great run by Wade Fleischer, who is an up man, knows how to run with a football. He's the big tight end, and he powers it back. A 12-yard return, and it's going to be first and 10 for the Broncos. They get a 14-yard return. They've got it at the 44-yard line. A great return, first and 10. Broncos at their own 44, but right now, Hastings must score at least 3 times. 8:28 to go. 17-0, Benedictine College. Bingman back in at quarterback. He drops back to the shotgun formation. Takes a snap. Looks, he's got a release man on the right side. Now he finally throws it to him, and he can't hold on. Sam Myers was in the backfield. He released and stayed in the right flat, waiting to take the pass. And as the rush of Jeff Grada came into Bingman, he was able to release the ball, but Myers could not hold on. It's incomplete, second down 10. Again, let me remind you that the Mar Hill Junior Ravens football game from Wichita, Kansas, as they look for the state championship in Class 4A, is going to be live on Care Radio. Jim Irvin will be bringing you that exciting game from Wichita with a pregame at about 4:40. Quarterback is back. Bingman looks downfield, has his man at the 45, at the Raven 40-yard line. Kenrock makes a tackle on Wade Fleischer, but it's another first and 10 for the Broncos. Fleischer comes up hobbling a little bit as Ken Romp put one of those knee-high tackles on, and he's going to check out of the game for just a moment. 8:10 to go, the clock winding. First and 10, Broncos, through at the Benedictine 40-yard line. First and 10 at the Raven 40. To the right side, Todd Athey. We haven't seen him catch a ball this afternoon to the best of my recollection. They may be looking for him here. And the pass to Athey, he's got it. Complete inside the 35 to the 32-yard line for a combination tackle by two Raven defenders. It is Tommy Hampton and Greg Bauer, a gain of about 8, 2nd and 2. You got to know the starting flanker back has got to be able to catch a football, and they simply had not gotten it into his hands until that particular play today. Two receivers again to the right side. Two backs, now motion man to the right side. All the receivers to the short side. Quarterback is back, sets up, fires it. Over the middle, it's batted and nearly picked off by McGivney through the hands of Ken Salyers. And McGivney had a shot at it and could not hold on. It's incomplete. Real safe play, third down and a yard. You can throw the ball and still have an opportunity. But again, third down safe because they're going for it on fourth down here, as they have done for virtually the entire second half. 17-0 Ravens, 7.5 minutes. Separate these teams from the end of the game. A full house in the backfield. Both ends are in tight on third and one. Right now, the Broncos just want their first down to keep the drive alive. The handoff to Whitten. He hits the middle. Great second effort. Gives him the first down and more. Whitten following some outstanding blocking, particularly that of 310-pound tackle Tony McKenzie, makes it first and 10. Kenny Romp tackling Flora Benedictine on that carry. First and 10 at the Raven 27-yard line. And the Broncos moving the ball downfield quite briskly at this point. 7:15 to go. From the gun, Bingman. Two to the right and one to the left. High snap, he fields it easily. Steps back to the 35. Fires a pass. It's complete at the 15. Finally, he's driven out of bounds. Athey is driven out of bounds across the way at the 15-yard line. 7:05 to go. Frank Goa makes the tackle for Benedictine. He'll get credit for that as he bumps Athey out of play. They're going to put him right at the 16-yard line, first and 10. City National Bank at 626 Commercial with the Motor Bank at 4th and Commercial. A couple of college playoff sponsors on Care. First and 10. And the Broncos moving the football here. They're at the Benedictine 16. Quarterback is back to throw. Sets up, steps up, fires a pass to the end zone, incomplete. Way over the head of intended receiver Brad McCaslin. And it goes incomplete. He was covered downfield by Arthur Westbrook in that man-to-man coverage. Big height mismatch right there. McCaslin at 6'3", Arthur Westbrook at 5'10". They picked out exactly the proper combination, the right mismatch to throw toward, but the pass by Bingman overthrown, and again, that wind at the quarterback's back. Perhaps more than they realize as far as carrying a football downfield. Motion man to the right side, quarterback in the gun. On the third and 10, looks downfield, short passes over the middle and out of the hands of Gordon Whitten. He had it, and then I think as he looked downfield, just simply lost the ball. It's fourth down. Third down and 10, 6:52 to go from the 16-yard line in Raven territory. Tony Martin's Dodge in Platte City. See Roman Steck for a great deal on a new or used vehicle. Another sponsor of Raven Playoff Football here on Care Radio. 6:52 to go. Clock stops with an incompleted forward pass. Once more from the shotgun formation, Roger Bingman. Motion man to the left side. He's back to throw. Steps back, looks downfield, looking still, throws a pass. It is incomplete. A leaping attempt by McRatslap of the football, and the Ravens converge on him. Now it's fourth down. Fourth and 10 at the 16.
senator, make sure I don't give a rat's ass. A
lot of conversation going out on the field, and toward that end, a timeout's going to be taken by Hastings, and we're going to take a timeout here. 6:45 to play in the football game. Timeout with the score, Benedictine 17, Hastings nothing. They'll go with a shotgun formation. Two men to the right side, one to the left. The back is going to stay in. 9 seconds on the play clock, and the snap is back. Quarterback looks downfield, pumps once, steps up, pumps again, has a man downfield. He's caught a touchdown. Beautiful pass, and it is caught in the deep corner of the end zone for the score. And coming up with the catch was Gordon Witten, and the Broncos are on the board. That is a great play, and we've got a Raven down on the field. Benedictine will send his training staff out to look at him. That is a great call. They're able to go ahead on fourth down. Hastings is now 3 of 3 in fourth down conversion attempts, and they've done an outstanding job of moving the football downfield on this series, putting it into the end zone, and with 6:38 to go in the ball game, drawing to within 11 of Benedictine. They continue to attend to Jeff Grata down on the field for Benedictine College. And the Ravens are going to put the extra point kick blocking team out there. See, I thought for a minute Benedictine thought they may have elected to go for two in this circumstance, but Hastings apparently, by bringing its kicker in, is going to go for a single point right here. You must keep in mind also that, you see, this is not one of those if you tie, you lose deals, because there is a tie-breaking formula in this ball game. And so with that in mind, Hastings has elected to go for the single extra point. And again, if they're able to come back and tie the game up, there is a tie-breaking formula. The tie-breaking formula is very simple. And after the fourth quarter, the referee is going to pick a goal. He says, this is the direction that you go. Coin is going to be tossed. The winner will be able to choose offense or defense. The ball is spotted at the 25-yard line. And it's a matter of who outscores whom with the football. 6:38 to go. 17-6. Thank you. They'll have a friendly crowd. They're only friendly because they're inside the warm room, I think. 17-6. And now the extra point attempt will come from Mitch Eckhart, the senior. He has been doing the punting and place kicking chores for a couple of years for this Hastings team. Hands outstretched as he waits to snap the ball. Very important, this extra point. It's down. It's on its way. And it is good. We've got a timeout on the field as Hastings is making a bid with 6:38 to go. The score, Benedictine 17 and Hastings 7. Onside. Benedictine expecting the onside kick has a group of ball handlers on the field, and the kick is away indeed. It's going to be taken by Brump at the 10 to the 15. He's at the 20. Hit and tumble to the ground at the 25-yard line. Ken Romp hit and pounded to the ground at the 25, and the Ravens, with 6:32 to go, are going to want to practice ball control offense. Jason Main makes the tackle for the Broncos. 6:32 to go. 17-7, Benedictine College on top. And the Ravens come back out with their offense on the field, led by senior quarterback Chris Tabor. To the left side, Benedictine will send Marcinowski and Perez in I formation. Harbison will shift to the tight end on the right. Now Perez motioned to the near side. Quarterback with a pitch to Brown. He's looking for a block. He's at the 20, at the 25. Drugged down from behind. A great, great tackle made. Individual tackle by Doug Herbeck. Herbeck got him about the ankles and held on and was just doing a great job to be able to stay with Don Brown. No gain on the play, second and 10 for Benedictine. 6:05 to play. The Ravens are going to be very patient, although they still have not dropped the no-huddle offense. Two receivers to the right side and an eye in the backfield again. 7 seconds on the play clock. Brown in motion to the left. The handoff, Torlein. He takes it to the right side, to the 27-yard line, where he's brought down by Gary Freeman. A gain of a couple of yards. Torlein hit the middle of the line and then selected to go to the right, which was to the outside. Only a couple of yards, a good individual tackle by Freeman. Benedictine really could use a first down or two here if they're wanting to maintain the momentum in the game, because it has now shifted back toward Hastings. After a great offensive series downfield to score in their last possession, now the defense has got Benedictine held to a third down and long, third down eight. Quarterback is back to throw. Throws left. Room to run if he should elect to do it. At the 25. Cuts back to the 30, 35. Tabor's to the 40. Tabor cuts across field and is dumped at the 44-yard line. Chris Tabor. What a move he put on a moment ago as he left a couple of defenders behind him. And it's first and 10. Benedictine and Roger Perkins makes the tackle. He may well have made the touchdown saving tackle. As I tell you what, Tabor had some pretty open field in front of him. Officials are going to take a moment. I don't know what the call is or why the delay, because he was nearly 10 yards beyond the first down marker, and they will advance the chains at the 45-yard line, first and 10 Ravens. 5 minutes to play in the ballgame. 17-7, Benedictine College leading Hastings. Last time these two teams met, the fall of 1981 here in Atchison. First and 10, Ravens at their own 45-yard line. Wing to the left side, single man in the backfield. Both ends are now in tight for the Ravens. The handoff to Brown, he's got nowhere to go. Breaks away, gets to the outside, but he's still got nowhere to go. It's a great pursuit of the defense. Drops him back at the 35-yard line. It'll be a loss of 10. But Don Brown was hit, looked like he was going to be tackled immediately upon having gotten the football from Tabor. Instead, he would break away from the first wave of defenders, but not the second group, who combined for an outstanding tackle and a loss of some 10 yards. They're going to make it a loss of 9 as they will spike the football at the 36-yard line. Don Hewlett, Jason Main, the first two defenders on the play, as we are approaching now 4 minutes to play in the game. Ravens leading at 17-7. A field goal has provided the Ravens with a very important margin of comfort at this juncture. Quarterback is back to throw, looking for Perez. Javier dives. Does he make the catch? Yes, at the 45-yard line. He picks up the 10 yards that were lost a moment ago on the sack of Don Brown, on the tackle for loss of Don Brown. And he will give Benedictine a second and, or third and 10. We're going to make it a gain. Frenzy's in the ballgame. I'm looking up here too. He's in the backfield under 3.5 minutes to go. And Pete Frenzy has come in the ballgame for Benedictine. We'll see where he goes. Tabor is running the ball club from his quarterback slot. And Frenzy, the tight end on the left side. It's kind of an interesting formation. Receivers left and right, and again an eye formation. The handoff to Brown, little draw play. Penalty markers everywhere as Brown will pick up about 3. Penalty markers thrown both sides of the line of scrimmage as Pulowski makes the tackle along with Perkins. We're going to have a procedural call against Benedictine College. 3:02 to play. Penalty may well be declined at this point. It would leave the Ravens facing a fourth down and probably 7. And so the officials will talk it over, make the indication it will be declined, and Benedictine will be facing fourth down. The punting unit will come on for the Ravens with 3:02 to go. 3 minutes and 2 seconds to play. And once again, the Broncos will have their hands on the football. And when you can get the ball back, anything certainly becomes possible. And they've already shown that Roger Bingman is capable of moving this football downfield in a hurry. He's able to throw that ball very well. Ravens thought the penalty was going to be assessed. Chandler is back deep, and not terribly deep. He's standing at his own 27-yard line, kicking into the wind. The snap is low. The kick is away. It's high. It's hanging. Taking on a run at the 28, at the 30, 35. Finally, the 40-yard line. The tackle made by Widlowski, who gets a hand on the return man, Steve Chandler. 2:32 to go in the game. 17-7.
14-8 Northwestern.
A third quarter score.
From the 40-yard line, their own 40-yard line, Hastings will have the football.
Baker University, 8.
In the third quarter, 14-8, you hear the roar of the crowd. Northwestern continues to lead Baker. Baker, no doubt, scored, ran for 2 to tie it. And then Northwestern scores another touchdown to get to 14. From the shotgun formation, Bingman, you've done a great job of moving this clock. Drops back to throw. Looking downfield with lots of time. Still look. The pass wide open on the near side. Taken by Witten. Little juke move to the 40. Finally bumped out of bounds. Inbounds. Inbounds at the 44-yard line. I thought maybe he was knocked out of play, but the official says no. The clock rolls at 2:14, 2:13. It'll be a gain of about 3, second down 7. Maybe, no, it's a gain of 4, second and 6 at the 44-yard line. Again from the gun. Quarterback is back to throw. Over the middle. Wide open and lost it at the 50. Wide open, Sam Myers, and he took a hit from Benedictine's Luke Brewster. That's a freshman saying, I want to get my licks in. Under 2 minutes now to play. 1:59 to go. It's 3rd down and 6. Hastings trailing Benedictine by 10, 17-7. And 3rd down and 6 from their own 44-yard line. You've got to be aware of Wade Fleischer, the big tight end. Bingman has been able to pick him out in a number of crucial situations. He has come through for them tremendously well. The snap is back. Quarterback sets up at the 35, steps up in the pocket, looking downfield, throws over the middle, and it's caught! And the tackle made on Nick Ratzlaff, but another first down for Hastings in Raven territory at the 35. And once again, Bingman with loads and loads of time to get rid of the football. Kenny Rump makes that tackle. And quickly downfield, the clock stops, and Hastings hustles up to the line of scrimmage with 1:52 to go. They are not out of this ball game. If they score quickly, kick an onside kick and get the ball back, anything could still happen. Deep drop again, Bingman. Looks downfield, continues to look and dance. Rolls to the left side now. Steps up, has a man, and it's nearly picked up. Incomplete. Luke Brewster stepped in front of Gordon Witten. Nearly was able to pull the ball down, couldn't hold on to it, and it goes incomplete. It is 2nd and 10 with 1:38 to go. 2nd down and 10 with 1:38 to play. Ravens clinging at this point to it. You'd think a 10-point lead to be comfortable, but for some reason it's just not in this game. You've got to have way too much respect for the Broncos to think that 10 is something that's insurmountable for them. 2nd down and 10. Back out of the football. Wide to the left side comes Tom Athey. Todd Athey to the left. Also receiver to the right. Wings both ways. Quarterback alone in the backfield. And Bingman takes the snap. He drops back. He steps up now. Looking downfield, and he's almost across the line of scrimmage. Shows the pass. It's caught by Fleischer. He's at the 15-yard line where it takes 3 Ravens to bring him to the ground. Hampton, the first Benedictine player in there to make the tackle. And he gets up walking a little sideways as he may have injured his left shoulder. Hampton is back wandering around the goal line trying to shake it off. 1st and 10. Hastings with 1:26 to go. Hampton continues to try to shake it off, and now the officials are going to say no. They're going to send in the Raven trainers to try to get a look at him. Say what? With a guy big as Wade Fleischer, you throw a shoulder into him, and you're liable to suffer much more than the ball carrier because he is such a big, strong kind of receiver. The wind continues to blow from the north at the backs of the Broncos with 1:26 to play. They'll break the huddle and step out over it. Athey goes wide to the right side. McCaslin will go to the left. Again, Bingman in the gun. 1st and 10 at the 15. Quarterback is back. Steps up in the pocket. Did a great job. He's got a little running room if he should elect to use it. Pass, it's complete. Touchdown! The pass complete at the goal line. Touchdown to Gordon Witten. And with 1:11 to go, a 15-yard touchdown pass from Roger Bingman to Gordon Witten. And now Hastings is within 4. 1:11 to go. We're going to have a timeout taken by Hastings. We're going to take this timeout as well. They're deciding about going for two. We'll take a timeout with 1:11 to go. Benedictine, 17. Hastings, 13. Hastings has elected to go for two, and the quarterback, Bingman, is back to throw. He sets up, fires, he's got a man wide open, it's gone! The two-point conversion is successful, and we've got a football game with a 1 minute, 11 seconds of play in the contest. We got a timeout on the field. The score, Benedictine 17, Hastings 15.
They used one timeout. See, that was a big one for them to use. Yeah. Using that timeout was important for a lot. We won't get more of that.
The kick by Hastings is an onside kick, and the officials say Hastings touched it before it had gone 10 yards. They're saying after 6 yards, one of the Broncos touched it at the 41-yard line. And if that's the case, the Benedictine offense will come onto the field. Now the Hastings coaches are out there. They're calling me. They're making some calls. And penalty markers sail. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Hastings. Hastings with the kick, and now the Broncos are absolutely furious on the field. Chris Pohl is really upset. One of the coaching staff had run out on the field. And I gotta tell you what, I've never seen anybody more upset than Chris Pohl is out there right now. Unsportsmanlike conduct, and another one, and another one. And here will come some more. Benedictine has just absolutely gotten away from the ball, and they're standing back, and they're going to allow Hastings to cause themselves problems they ought not to have had to contend with. A minute 10 to go. The football is going to be in the Ravens' hands. The call by the official was that one of the Broncos touched it around the 41-yard line. It had to travel at least 10 yards in order to be a live football. Benedictine, of course, could have run up on it and grabbed it, or attempted to grab it before that. But for the kicking team to be able to touch the ball, it had to be at least 10 yards downfield. They're assessing the penalties now, one after the other. A minute 10 to go. And now they are going to move it back downfield. They have moved it deeper and deeper. And is there yet another one or not? Are the officials going to come up, or is this the last spot of the ball? It's already inside the 15. It's at the 14-yard line with a minute 10 to go. They've got it inside the 15. It has to be called the 14-yard line. Tabor has a single man behind him. It's Brown. Quarterback, hands off. Don Brown looking for the outside. He's at the 15. Brown stiff arms at the 10. He's drugged down at the 5-yard line. He'll be close to a first down, and the clock does not stop. They're letting the clock continue to run. And a ball game that became very exciting for just a second. It's going to be stopped by the official. They're going to bring the chains in from across the way, and this is going to be very, very close to the first down mark with 52 seconds to go. And the crowd on both sides has been shocked and stunned and then brought to life and then shocked again. It's been a tremendous up and down ball game for the fans. The officials stretch the chains. They're on their hands and knees looking it over, and it looks from here like it's first down yardage, but we haven't gotten the official mark yet. The Raven players on the field inciting the crowd to get to their feet. We've got the chain stretch up, but again, we have no indication from the officiating crew whether it's a first down, although again, it certainly would appear to be from here.
What are we discussing? I have no idea what the problem or the discussion may be. Now they're over talking to the Raven coaching staff for just a moment. The guy who has to make the indication does. First and goal, Benedictine at the 4-yard line. 56 seconds to play. I'll tell you, if Benedictine should score again, you'll never know how close this game really was going to be if they punch it in and makes it look something like 24-5 to 15. Tabor comes out from the near sideline where he had visited with the powers that be for the Ravens and brings a play out. Clock rolls, 50 seconds to play, 20 on the play clock. Will they try to run it in or do they just drop on it a couple times? Interesting decision. Tabor, with a very long count, takes a snap, gives it to Brown. He hits the outside and is going to be dropped at the 4. A great tackle made by Jason Main and a timeout, I think. Have we had a timeout taken? We have. We are going to take a timeout here also. 32 seconds of play in today's first ball game. The score, Benedictine 15, Hastings, or Benedictine 17, Hastings 15. Welcome back to Amelia Earhart Stadium. The Ravens are going to just step back and down the football, and they're going to let this clock wind down. We will see if Hastings calls another timeout or not. 22 seconds, 21. The Ravens will not have to put the ball in play another time. 15 seconds to go. Benedictine's team comes out on the field. The Hastings players, in a gesture of great sportsmanship, come over and shake the hands of Benedictine in a game that ultimately became as close as the score indicates. There's going to be a victory by Benedictine this afternoon, 17-15, over a very scrappy, a very young, and a very talented Hastings Broncos football team. The coaches shaking hands in the middle of the field, the teams getting together in the middle of the field, shaking hands, and we will be back. Recap the scoring of the game, tell you a little bit about it, hope to get a chance to visit with Larry Wilcox, the head coach of the Ravens, and don't forget, more football coming up on KIT Radio. We'll talk about that too, all that when we return in just 1 minute.